your pretext! Get up there, take him out! He's find that phone. Make a call. There's gotta be a landline in that office, man. I think we'll be all right.
Yeah, at least for a little while.
Let me just call somebody, get a little help, and we'll get out of here. Hey, it's me. Look, we really need to get out of New Jersey. Yeah, the things are heating up. We got like half the New Jersey mob after us. And a cemetery in Hoboken.
Here I was again, halfway down the world, and still looking at the bodies of women I was supposed to protect. Only difference now is, I didn't understand the language.
Gringo! Vá! Vá! Vai pra lá! Tranquilo! Tranquilo! Pode ficar tranquilo! Fica nessa parede, seu americano de merda! Que porra tá acontecendo aqui? Que merda tá acontecendo aqui?
Haven't you figured out? I don't speak your fucking language!
Seu gringo de merda! Cala a boca, seu gringo!
That's right, I may be a moron, but here's the thing. I ain't quite as dumb as I seem.
It was time to get out of there. Seemed like someone had decided to carry out some impromptu justice on the street life below. I'd failed Rodrigo and I'd failed Fabiana. In that awful nightclub, the stadium, the docks. I'd been given enough chances to make this right, and again I'd blown it. Perhaps this was my punishment from the fates. Keep reliving the same mistakes for all eternity. Didn't seem too concerned with meeting their arrest quotas. Between me and Sao Paulo's finest, it'd be a miracle if the CS were still in business by the end of the day. I had to get that image of Fabiana out of my head. It was a goddamn war zone. I had to assume Giovanna and Marcella were out there somewhere. Maybe I still had a chance to get somebody in that family through the day in one piece. Swarming with cops. They weren't there for me, as far as I could tell. And I'd blundered my way into enough clusterfucks for one day. If these fools could buy me some time, I might have a chance to get to Marcello and Giovanna before somebody put a bullet in their heads, too. Yeah. Ivana and Marcella were still alive, but I didn't hold out much hope they'd stay that way for long. I'd already lost the ransom money, got the hostage killed, and I was only just getting started. This was turning into another fine example of private security work. Thugs in body armor sending a message to the poor that the cops are still in charge. When they hit the favelas, they came in hard and fast. It was fair game, as I was about to find out. Me getting out of there alive, let alone Giovanna and Marcello, were narrowing with every passing second.
Thank you.
There was a danger of this starting to get too real. I was still alive, and still not all that happy about it. Why did the easy way out never come? Maybe I thought I didn't deserve it.
Filho da puta!
Atira agora!
filho da puta!
Chefe, seu filho da puta!
Não, mano, eu não sei nada, porra. Eu tô indo pra casa, mano. Eu tenho família, eu tô
um saco na cabeça desse
merda! Não!
I was guessing these guys didn't spend their spare time studying the Geneva Convention. Jesus Christ, these bastards weren't playing games. These were the same paramilitary cops I had seen executing fools after the failed kidnapping at the party. Nasty business. If these were the guys Da Silva was worried about, maybe he had a point. Yes, this was definitely them. Jesus Christ, these bastards made the NYPD look like the Hare Krishnas. I couldn't make much sense of what I was seeing, but I had the feeling it wasn't that strange for anyone else. No option but to take the scenic route. These charmers weren't there to make a couple of arrests. They were bussing them out by the dozen. But who was I to cast judgment on proper police procedure and justifiable use of force?
Nunca prende eles, são traficantes e viciados, né? Espero o quê?
Traficantes e viciados, né? Espero que. nunca aprende a lição.
Traficantes e viciados, né? Espero o quê?
Merda, eles nunca aprendem a lição.
Traficantes e viciados, né? Espero que...